DB and DC. But DC is a separate region. DB is for storing data. Hold on. A graph. Okay. DB is for storing data and DC is for data communication. A DB can be used in online also. An IMS is a hierarchical structure. It was introduced in 1960s. And basically, it's an inverted tree structure. If you invert a tree, a root comes to the top. So there we, in IMS, we have mini records. Each mini record is called a segment name or segment type. It's called a mini record, contained a group of fields. So we can have maximum 255 segments in IMS. And a segment at the top of the hierarchy is called a root segment. A segment at the top of the hierarchy is called root segment. It's an independent segment. There is no parent for this. So when we write in a DBT, we give parent equal to 0. There can be as many children as you want, but we cannot exceed maximum 255 segments. The root segment is in level 1. How many levels we can have in IMSDB? Totally?
15 levels.
An IMSDB can be designed in such a way, we have a root segment at the top and we have
child at the bottom,
and we can maintain parent-child relationship. We can have parent-child relationship, and we can, each segment is called a mini record, contain group of fields, and we can have 15 levels and 255 segments. A single DB record, a 1 DB record is nothing but, what is a 1 DB record? Is nothing but a root occurrence.
Root and its children.
Root occurrence and all its children. All its child occurrences. And child is optional. Okay, child is optional. Child can be 0 to many. Okay, so a structure is hierarchical structure, and we have something called hierarchical path. A hierarchical path is nothing but it starts from the root and goes all the way down to the lowest level child. Okay, for example, if you have a database like this, there are 3 paths. This is one path, this is second path, and this is third path. This is called as hierarchical path. It's also an interview question. A segment, what is segment occurrence? A segment occurrence is nothing but
actual data in segment.
So data in the segment we call as a segment occurrence. So this is the structure we design, and then we store data in a hierarchical fashion, and the data is called as segment occurrence. So as far as a database concerned, we can store as many child you want, and the number of records you can store also as many. The limit is huge. So we can, ideally we can store huge data. So if you compare with DB2, a single segment can be compared with a DB2 table. So because you can contain, so you can store all the data in up next to next, we say IMS is faster when compared to DB2, because in DB2 data is scattered in different tables, and tables can be in any storage. If you want to get data from many tables, you are going to do a join and then retrieve. But here data is present next to next in storage. Okay, and relationships are pre-established. We are establishing a relationship, a parent-child relationship. So relationships are pre-established. Their relationships are established by way of foreign key. Otherwise, if you can join data and join two tables, more than two tables, and get data. So in that way also you can retrieve data. So IMS is faster when compared to DB2, but IMS is a very complex structure. If you go more than 3 levels, it becomes very complex to retrieve and store. So DB2 is better when compared to IMS. And DB2 is also RDBMS. We can have foreign key relationship. Someone asked me yesterday, can we have any functions for IMS? We don't have any functions. Because in DB2, we are going to use SQL for maintaining DB2 tables. So in SQL, there are plenty of functions. So it makes life much more easier when compared to IMSDB. But IMSDB is used a lot in your projects. That's why I've learned IMSDB. So it's hierarchical structure. and 1 db record is this, and segment occurrence. And every database will have a db. If you take a IMS db, it includes a database description, which is structure, and it is includes a storage. A storage is going to be based on what access method you are using. So DBD stands for database description. It's a control block. So as far as IMS control blocks are concerned, there are three control blocks. So what are those control blocks?
DBD, PSP, ACB.
PSP and ACB.
So DBD stands for database description. Description means it is going to describe the database. So DBD is going to contain the database name. It is going to contain the access method you are going to use. And it is going to give the DD names you are going to use. It is going to give the parent-child relationship and segments, fields, etc. Okay, and you can give a primary key field will be in root segment. We are going to mention with sequence and unique. Even you can give sequence and unique for any field in child, but it is not a primary key. So this is a structure of database. Storage is based on the access method you are choosing. Suppose if we have used HiSAM. So if you use HiSAM, you are going to use KSDS and ESDS. HiSAM is very commonly used. And here KSDS is called as primary data set, ESDS is called as overflow data set. So when database is stored in a hierarchical fashion, first it is going to insert data in KSDS. Anything which is greater than, if you have more data, it is going to store into the overflow data. So this is called primary and overflow. As you are aware, KSDS is a key sequence data set. It is going to have key. So if you take any DB record in IMS, it's a variable length record, because child is optional. A record is nothing but one root segment and all its child occurrences. For example, if you take one root, if you take a database which has one root and one child, so the record is just only two segment occurrence. Suppose if you take another DB record which has one root and 10 child occurrences, then it is going to have totally 11 occurrences. So record is variable length. A single record is variable length. Every record it will try to store in a KSDS, and anything which is left over will be stored in ESDS. That's why it is called as overflow data set. This is one control block. For creating this, we are going to use a process called DBDGen. Okay, DBDGen is a process which is we are going to compile the DBD and store in a PDS called DBDLib. Okay, it's a PDS. Even if a project also, you'll be seeing DBDLib PDS, which is going to have the load model of the DBD. And the high level qualifier may be different. It will not be same like what you are seeing in training. High level qualifier may be starting with IMS star. If you put IMS star dot star dot DBDLib, you will get it. Or IMS star dot, if you want, you can note down this. IMS star dot star star means any number of qualifier. DBDLib. You can find out which is the DBDLib in your projects. Okay, otherwise it'll be system.star.dbdlib. It is going to show you which is your DBDLib library. But anyway, so your seniors may be helping you. But if you want to see in any other company, either it'll be starting with sys or sys1, sysca, sysb, IMS, etc. Okay, this name will be changing. Here double star means any number of qualifiers in the middle. Okay, the names will be different in every project. Here in training also different. A DBDGen is a process which is going to compile the DBD which is written in assembler macros, compile and create the load. Okay, similarly we have PSBGen which is going to store in PSBLib. And we have ACBGen, which is going to store in ACBLib. Okay, so DBD is nothing but this. So what is PSB? PSB is Programs View of Database. PSB is Programs view of database. Programs view of database, it can contain more than one PCB. Program communication block contains more than one PCB, which is program communication block, each PCB pointing to one database. Pointing to a DB, and PCB also can point to a can have type equal to TP, okay, teleprocessing, which we learned in IMSDC. I'll come to IMSDC, then I'll let you know about that. So PSB is a program's view of database. Why it is called as program's view of database? Because whatever segments we want to access is going to be listed in PSB. So a database can have 10 segments, but if a program is going to access only 2 segments, only those segments will be mentioned in PSB, and the program can access only those segments, and your cursor is going to move only assuming that is a structure. So programs is nothing but program's logical structure of database. That's why it's called program's view of database. The physical structure may be big. It can contain these many segments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But the logical structure will be like this, whatever you have mentioned in SENSEC field. So your cursor is going to move only in the logical structure, not in the physical structure. So PSB stands for program specification block. It's another IMS control block. It is also written in assembler macro. If you want to compile, and you are going to use PSB gen compilation JCL, it contains two steps, compilation and link edit. It is going to create a load and store in PSB live load module PDS. It is nothing but program's view of database, because whatever structure, the logical structure you are mentioning by way of SENSEC field, is the only structure available to the program. And it is going to contain PCB. PCB stands for program communication block. Each PCB is going to point to a database. So if you, for any IMS program, we need one PSB. Usually in projects, the PSB name and program name will be same. Okay, but it might be different also. It will be same, but it may be different also. But in online, it will be same. In online means IMSDC, it will be same. In batch, it may be same or may be different. But there will be some relation. For example, if a program name is COP001, so COP001P will be your PSB name, something like that. Okay, that you will know. It depends on project to project. So what is the use of, in PSB, we are going to, apart from mentioning the sensitive segments, we are going to also mention processing option. Okay, processing option. So what are the processing options available for the database, for the program? So what are the processing options available? So processing option is
G A I L P.
P we cannot give separately, we give AP, GP, etc. Yes. Processing option is maximum 4 bytes. You can give GIRD also, like this. Okay, but here GP, G and AP are most commonly used. Processing option can be given in database level as well as SENSEC level also. If it is given both in database level and sensitive segment level, whatever you are given in sensitive segment level is going to take priority when compared to whatever you mentioned in database level. So it is going to tell what processing what access your program is having for the database. Okay, so we have another segment. We have here sensitive segment. It's called SENSEC macro, and optionally we can have send field, SENFLD, where if you mention a field name, only those field names are available to the program. So using PSB and PCB, we can establish security, data security. So whatever program has to see, only those segments is listed in PSB. So we can enforce data security using PSB. And the PSB is must for any IMS program. It could be a online or batch. Okay, and ACB. Next we'll come to ACB. And ACB is a combination of DBD and PSB. So ideally, a program requires ACB. Okay, ideally a program requires ACB, but in batch, when you're running executing program in batch, dynamically created. Okay, in batch, dynamically created. dynamically created means during runtime. System is going to create during runtime. But we cannot afford for this wastage of time in online. So in online, it has to be created before. Usually administrator will create an online. So here I was creating for everyone. Okay, for everyone, I created ACB. I mean, ACB gen would have been in your IMS DC library, where it is going to execute. It is going to combine the DBD and PSB and create a load and store in online. So primarily in online, it is pre-created. Okay, in online, it is pre-created. Because we cannot dynamically create it, it will be wastage of time. Because in online, performance is very important. In batch, it's okay. Even if you wait for seconds, minutes, doesn't matter. In online, no one is going to wait more than a second. So these are the control blocks. So database description control block, PSB, program specification block, and ACB, okay, alternate control block. If you want, you can take a screenshot. I'm going to rub this. I'll move on to the next. Someone is recording, right?
Yes, sir.
So now let's see how a IMSDB program is going to execute. If you take IBM mainframe hardware, it is going to be operated by the operating system. Under this, we have a region control program. This program is called DFS RR C00. So in this is the program we are going to execute. We are going to pass three major parameters to this program. So which we are going to pass as DLI or BMP for batch. Okay, and we are going to give program name and then PSB name. So this is second parameter and PSB name is third parameter. So these are three parameters we are going to give as a part of this. And when you're executing a program, your program is going to be executing under region control program. So when the go back is issued in the program, it sends control back to the region control program. And when the region control program is ended, it is going to send control back to the operating system. So here in the program, so we have a very important statement, which is the entry statement. Either you can give entry statement or you can use procedure division using statement. Both are fine. So in entry statement, we are going to give a state min command min. We are going to call a load module DLI to COBOL. So here, this statement is going to connect your program with the database through PCBs. Okay, it's going to connect your program with the database through PCBs. So connect means what? So it is going database address are going to be sent to the program. So when the address is only if the address is given, we can read some data, right? Everything is addressed in hardware. So this is the command which is going to connect your application program with the database through PCBs or PSB. We can say what PSB. How it is going to connect PCB database addresses are passed to the program in this statement. This is the first statement in any IMS program where the program is going to get connected to the IMSDB. Once it is connected, it can start giving any calls. And here, this entry statement is going to have a using keyword along with PCB mask. PCB mask is nothing but a DLI communication area. Okay, PCB mask nothing but DLI communication area. This is going to be listed in a linkage section. In linkage section, you can give this PCB mask, okay. Described in linkage section. So in linkage section, it can be given in any order, but in the entry statement, this order, whatever you are given, will be exactly mapped to the PCBs in your PSB. So every call statement. Every call statement is going to have this PCB mask. Using this PCB mask, we are going to identify which database and segments your call is accessing. Okay, only using this PCB mask. because you have to, when someone asks how do you find which database your call is accessing, you have to see, you have to just find out from the PC mask, you have to go to the entry statement, see the which is the means which is sequence in the entry statement, and then see the open the PSB, see the sequence of PCBs, then try to map. Then only you will know which database or segments your call is accessing. So PC mask is nothing but a DLA communication area. Okay, DLA communication area. Like how you have a SQL communication area, we have DLA communication for IMS DB. So this communication area will be filled by system. Okay, any communication area of system is going to be filled by system. We are not going to fill this. Okay, system is going to fill after every call statement. So this communication, so if you aren't going to use any calls, if you're going to use IMS DB in your program, you are going to have two major definitions. One is the entry statement. Second, I mean, giving all the PC mask or describing all the PC mask in linkage section. Once these two are given, you can start writing calls. Okay, as far as a call is concerned, if you take any call, it's going to be COBOL to DLI. From COBOL, you're going to ask DLI by passing four major parameters. One is function. Next one is going to be PCB mask. Any one of PC mask described in entry statement, then IO area, and followed by SSA. So these are the four parameters you're going to pass as a part of your call statement. So once you're giving entry statement, and describing the structure, PC mask structure, linkage section, you are ready to give any calls. Okay. And in addition to this, there are five parameters where you can have one more parameter in front of function. Okay. That is going to be a control parameter. It's a S904 comp variable that is going to contain how many parameters are present in the call statement, including that control parameter. But that is optional, that's why we are not using. But that parameters are is mandatory for PL-1, because IMS can be used in PL-1 language, assembler language, and EC tree also. In fact, can be used in IMS, I mean C, C++, Java also, but it's never used. So PL-1 it is using. So in PL, if you are using IMS in PL-1, it's going to be PLI to DLI. In assembler, it's going to be ASM to DLI. In EC tree DLI. So these three are few more languages available in mainframe, but COBOL is the most used language. Okay, so this is the call parameter, COBOL to DLI. So what we are doing, we are sending a request to DLI. So call is going to send a request to DLI module. DLA module is going to access the database. And we have access method also in front of this. Because access methods are nothing but the way we are going to see the data. The data can be stored in any manner, but the way we are going to see the data is decided by access method. So DLA module is going to serve the request. It's accessing an interface between a program, because this is a program. So if anyone asks what is DLI, you can say DLI modules are going to be an act. It's a type of processing. It's a DLI module. Okay, here DLI module is going to be acting as an interface between your program and database. It is going to serve the request of your call statement. It is going to send and receive data using this DLI module. So what are the different function codes?
GN,
hold calls.
Yes,
so these are the function codes. PC mask is going to be nothing but PC mask you are given in entry statement and described in linkage section. IO area, at any point of time, how much data will be there in IO area? Only one segment occurrence, except for the path call. in path call, the entire path data will be in IO area. Otherwise, in all the any other call, only there's one segment occurrence. And how many SSIs you can give maximum?
15 each level.
15. So it's 15. And for each level one. You can give one SSA. Okay, so let's come to the function code, a GU. If we take a GU, so it's nothing but get unique. It is going to read from top of database and stop when it is finding a match, when it found a match. Match means whatever you are given in SSA. So if you give a call, it is better to give as many SSA as you can. So the call is going to be much more efficient. Even if you give more than one SSA, the lowest level SSA data will be in IO area. And the cursor also will be in lowest level SSA. If you give many SSAs, it is going to jump from one SSA to, it is going to basically search. Okay, that all these are temporary search. And it is going to finally end at the lowest level SSA and the cursor will stop there. And wherever it stops, we say a parentage is set if it's a call. Always reads from top of database and proceed, okay, in a hierarchical fashion and stops even it founds a match. So anyway, any call is going to be in hierarchical fashion. The hierarchical fashion, and you are aware how the hierarchical fashion works. Okay, and what are the status codes for this?
GE.
Spaces and GE.
GE.
GE means what? Not found.
Not found.
GE means not found. Because it's a random read. Get unique means random read. So when you're reading a random, either it is found or it is not found. So GE, you will be getting GE. So GU call usually will have qualified SSA. Okay, usually will have qualified SSA. Even if you give unqualified SSA, also it will work. If it gives unqualified SSA, it is going to stop at the very